Hey guys, it's Danielle. Today I am going to be playing a game that I found in the free-to-play section on Steam. It's called When the Past Was Around, and it is the Prologue. I don't know a whole lot about this game, I just thought that the artwork was really pretty, and I like that it's like an illustration sort of style, and so that drew me to it, and I wanted to see what it was about. So let's play. It's looking like it is a point-and-click sort of adventure game. These drawers look like they're locked, and there's nothing in there. Let's put on... I guess we don't get to put on shoes? Oh, there's an owl key. And a girl key. Let's look this way. I guess the boxes don't open. Okay. So then we'll look this way. And there's nothing in these boxes either. Okay. Don't want to restart. Just trying to get a hang of this and figure out maybe if the question marks mean something. Not a whole lot of explanation here. Seems like there's something in the box, maybe. Oh, maybe the keys go to the drawers. Okay, so we have a picture with a face missing from it. And then... we have a box cutter. And a feather? Okay, so it looks like maybe we're rebuilding part of her memory of whatever this person or creature is. Some sort of handle. Oh, okay. This down. 1, 4, 3, 4, 6, 4, 1. Okay. I can't ever remember codes unless I write them down. Some sort of broken handle. There's the handle. There's a lot to do with keys for this game, I'm noticing. Okay, I get it. The pictures over here had the shapes and the numbers. So, circle is 6, heart is 2, triangle is 7, butterfly shape is 5, leaf is 3, star is 4, and rectangle is, or square is 1. Let's start by going back over here, and we'll add this piece. Does this not go to this? Oh, okay. One piece at a time. And I'm guessing, does this go on here maybe? And then the key. And the owl? Okay. Now we'll try the piano. And so the first number from that code was 1. And so 1 is square. And then 4. Three. Okay, looks like they might already be in number order anyway. 4. 6. 4 and 1. So there's the piece. Cool. Ah, we get another feather. Some sort of owl man. Interesting. The artwork in this game is really making me want to go draw. Okay, now we're in some sort of like living room, maybe kitchen. Okay, there's something in there. Okay, we can turn it off. Get that. Just break the plant, I guess. Red. Okay. Wow. This game does not like a stuffed plants. Okay, maybe this is the key for this journal? Nope. Oh, that makes sense. It's a hand for the clock. Alright. Faucet. Why does it want us to break all the plants? Okay. I'm guessing we use this sponge to clean the mirror. 1915. 1 9. One. 5? Maybe that doesn't go to that? I don't know. Bread in the blender. So we now have bread crumbs. Breaking more stuff. Oh, okay. Bird has a letter. Oh, with another hand for the clock. Okay. which the journal is still locked. It looks like there's a pry bar in there. Okay, one. Nine. One. Is it 1915? And then 15. Yep. Okay. I didn't think of that originally because I live in America. And of course we do like everything differently. So telling time is a bit different. That is a huge crate for a tiny key. Haha! There is the feather. Where to now? Because it looks like he's mostly belt, unless maybe his shirt? It's pretty. Interesting. Wasn't expecting that. Interesting. Alright, so that's the end of the prologue, I guess. It seems like a nice little teaser introduction. I don't know if they're gonna like continue this or if it was just like an overall teaser for like their game studio and for their art style and their potential ideas for further games, since it had that little message at the end to support their gaming company. But I definitely want to look more into them now, and I really like the art style. It's really cute and feels like storybook, kind of makes you wanna know more about it and maybe even make some artwork of your own. Thanks for joining me today, guys. I'll see you next time. Goodbye.